Hi, this is Tommy with Teardrop Rental. So today I'm actually going to give an overview of the 2021 Solo that I actually rent out on my site. So I'm going to go ahead and start at the front of the Teardrop, and I'm going to go thoroughly through what is present with the Teardrop today. All right, so let's go ahead and head to the front and we will go through it, and then we'll go through the middle and then we'll go through the back. All right, let's see the front. Okay, so now we're at the front of the Teardrop. I'm actually going to flip the camera around and I'm going to explain everything at the front. And then if you have any questions while we go through this, please write them down. And then when you and I are in person, we can go through the questions. Okay. Okay, so right here, we have a 2-inch coupling with the lock itself. The lock comes with the trailer when you rent it. I will give you the key for it. So anytime that you leave the trailer by itself, like you detach the towing vehicle from the trailer, you can go ahead and lock it up so no one will be able to run off with the trailer. Okay. And here is the bar that controls that pushes this down so it levels the trailer out. That is your propane tank. Right will tighten it, left will release the gas. Okay, I'm sorry, release the propane. And of course the cords. Here is the battery. The battery will control the fan and the lights. That's the only thing the battery actually controls, is the fan and the light. Okay, let's go over here to this side. We have the breakaway brake. So what this does, this will actually hook up to the towing vehicle. Just in case the trailer comes apart from the towing vehicle, this will hit the brakes on the Teardrop so it won't go any further. Here is your 7-way plug. This plugs in to the towing vehicle to control the brakes. And then you have your hookup chains, okay? So that is the front of the Teardrop. We're gonna go ahead now and move to the actual middle part of the Teardrop where you will be sleeping, okay? All right, so here is the actual inside of the Teardrop. We have the top, of course, that has storing capability. And then you also have storing capability right behind here. There's a nook. And then here we have our drawers that you put, they move side to side. And then over there is actually the switch that controls the light on the outside. And then of course your cabinets and your AC unit. The AC unit is actually only going to work when it's plugged in. And that goes with the heater also. So the heater and AC will only work when it's plugged in. There we go. And there is your fire extinguisher, your lights, and then the fan. So the fan will run on the battery, like I was saying. All you have to do is hit the on button, and then if it rains, you just hit this and it will actually close off the top where the rain will not get in. And over here, we have the fire extinguisher. And then you have your mattress, of course. So this is a 3-inch foam mattress on top of a 2-inch mattress. This is not very comfortable, so that's why I went ahead and bought this for it. And then if we come over here, we're actually going to see the radio. And the radio is a Bluetooth, so it will actually hook up to Bluetooth. And then you have down here, that is a sensor for if any time that carbon monoxide leaks in here, that will actually go off. And then you have your plug off to the side. And that's pretty much it for the inside of the Teardrop. Okay. So now we're going to move to the back of the Teardrop. All right. So now we're at the back of the Teardrop and you can see that you have a 2-burner stove with the water hose. Pretty simple, you just squeeze it and the water will come out. You have your sink, no garbage disposal, unfortunately. And then you have your cooler. It's just a standard cooler that will actually lock into place when you're on the road. And then up here, we have storage capability that you can put your spices, your knives, your plates, and so forth. And then over here, your speakers, that so you can hear your Bluetooth radio and so forth. Okay. So that is the back of the Teardrop. All right, so now that we've gone over the front, the inside, and the back of the Teardrop, we're actually going to now go over the outside of the Teardrop, okay? So let's follow me around and we'll go over the outside. Okay, so right here is where the clean water will go. And then right here is your plug. So if you would like to plug it in at a campsite or when you're at home to charge it up, that's where the plug would go. And this is the, when the heater is on, this will blow out hot air. And so you don't want to ever stand in front of this when this is going off, okay? And then under here, you're gonna see a lever right there. That's that blue. That will actually release all the water that is in the tank in case you need to dump it and then reload it, okay? And of course your tires. And then this little guy, which is stored underneath both mattresses and in a bin right there, this is stored there. So what this does, this will hook onto here and you'll just go ahead and spin it with that and it will release those. There's one on the other side. It will release these to level out the Teardrop. Okay, so now we're on the other side of the Teardrop. As you can see up here, this is your awning. And the awning is going to be covered in another video of how to open that and how to put that together, because it's kind of extensive on how to do that. All right, so now that we've gone over the 2021 Solo, if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me by email, by text, or even give me a call and I will be happy to go over that with you. Have a great night and I will talk to you later. Bye.